He was on one of my favorite TV shows of all time, Breaking Bad, as the brother-in-law, Hank Schrader, who was trying to put Heisenberg behind bars. And now he is on new episodes of The United States of Al that airs tonight at 8:30 p.m. Eastern on CBS. He is Dean Norris. How are you, Dean?
I'm fantastic, man. How you doing?
I'm doing better for having you on this show. Like I told you a little bit of moments ago off air, I'm a big fan. So thanks for doing this.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
I appreciate that. So let's jump in, if you don't mind, real quick to your sports fandom. I have been told through other little birdies who might be right or wrong. Are you a Denver Bronco fan? Is that a true story?
That's not a true story, no.
No, what are you a fan of, then?
Well, I grew up in Southland, Indiana, so my main fandom, of course, is Notre Dame University.
Okay. You know, I'm a Michigan Wolverine who thinks Rudy was offsides. Are you aware of that, Dean?
Well, great, that's a great rivalry. And professionally, I've always been, now I'm an L.A. Rams because we finally have a team here in Los Angeles. Previously, since I grew up in South Bend, I was a Bears fan.
So you grew up in South Bend, Indiana. So you are Notre Dame through and through, huh?
Oh, yeah. They stamp it on you. You can't get out of there without being a Notre Dame fan. You get beat up, you know. So.
Okay, so who was, when you were growing up there and being around there, was Montana the guy?
Montana. I saw Montana when he came in. I remember that game, and he came in as a substitute, and then it was a hero after that. Roger Clemens. Do you remember Roger Clemens?
Okay, sure, yeah.
Those guys. And of course, we would wake up on Sunday, and the South Bend Tribune would have like full pages of color photos of the game. It was just glorious to kind of wake up and read through that.
Wow! Yeah, like I said, I'm a Michigan Wolverine. I'm from New York City, and I went to Michigan. And my senior year of college was the year, and it was the year I got to cover Bo Schembechler's Michigan Wolverines.
Wow.
And it wound up being Bo's last season.
Wow.
And the first game was the one where Rocket Ishmael opened it with a touchdown run on a kickoff. And Bo famously went in the locker room and told the Wolverines that we're going to kick it to that damn Rocket and we're going to put that damn Rocket on his ass. And he ran it back the other way for a touchdown and basically ruined the national championship hopes of Bo Schembechler in his final season right off the bat. I was there for that one. And thus, part of my animosity.
That was a spectacular run, though, man.
Yes, it was, Dean Norris. Yes, it was.
Like he felt like he was a deer, like, he had some quote about how he felt running that back. He was like a deer, and people were, you know, just aiming for him or something like that.
Yeah, and they couldn't catch him.
And they couldn't catch him, yeah.
They could not catch him. Okay, yeah. So Notre Dame, how about that? Because I don't know why. Somebody told me you were a Bronco fan, but I got that bad news, bad information. Dean Norris here on the Rich Eisen Show. The first time you received a script to Breaking Bad was when?
Somewhere around January, the 1st of January of whenever that year was, 2007 maybe?
Okay, sure. And so what did you think of when you received that script?
Well, I'll give you a little background. Please. I had been up for a pilot previously that fall that I thought was the best script I'd ever read, and I was perfect for the role. And they were about to – it looked like it was going my way – and I was a son of a matriarch, and they changed the matriarch, the lead, and I no longer looked like I could be the son of that person. Mm-hmm. And I was brokenhearted. And I'm like, that was the best role I could have ever had, and there'll never be another role like that. 6 months later, or 4 months later, I guess, 5 months later in January, I get the script for Breaking Bad. And I'd say the same thing. I'm like, holy moly, like, this is the best script I've ever read. Mm-hmm. And I know I'm perfect for this role, but I had kind of like, scars from the last one. And so I went and met Vince Gilligan, and things worked out.
So I have to ask, did they ever make the other show that you didn't get?
I'll tell you, I won't say the name of it, but they made it and never made it to air.
Huh.
How about that?
So, thank God they changed the matriarch, right?
Exactly. I'd be on a show that never made it, and I wouldn't have been in Breaking Bad.
Oh, Oh my gosh. So, what is your favorite episode of Breaking Bad, Dean Norris?
Well, I always go to episode 307. That's called 1 Minute, where it's kind of famously known for where the Mexican assassins try to chop my head off.
Mm-hmm.
But I like the scene, a couple scenes prior to that, where I sit with my wife, Marie, played by Betsy Brandt, mm-hmm. and I just say that I'm just, you know, the universe is telling me something, and I'm not sure I'm going to be a cop anymore. And it was just, to me, it was such a meaningful, and, you know, a man like Hank Schrader admitting that, you know, he's not who he thought he was just a really touching moment in my view. And I just forever remember that speech and that episode for that.
Well, we've had Vince Gilligan. Vince Gilligan was the first ever in-studio guest in the history of this show 7 years ago.
Wow.
Because I met Vince in an airport and fanboyed him longer than that ago. And, you know, I'm the host of NFL Network outside of this, Dean. And, you know, I talked a little sports with him, and he basically said, and I invited him on my podcast, and he's like, I don't know anything about sports at all. I said, I don't care. I know everything about Breaking Bad. And I've gotten to know him and his brilliance. And, you know, we've had Giancarlo Esposito, also, you know, the great Bryan Cranston as well. And Bryan told a story about the scene where, you know, Kristen Ritter, the actress who played,
yeah,
you know, Jesse Pinkman's girlfriend, and he let her die.
Oh.
And how he saw his own daughter in her face, and how it created such a moment for him as an actor. Did you have a moment where you needed to pause a second after acting in a scene in Breaking Bad?
I'll be honest with you, Dean? Pretty much the entire last season, starting with the garage scene where I confront Bryan, which he directed, and which was an amazing day in my career and life, filming that scene where I shut the garage door and confront Bryan. After that day, pretty much the end, I was depressed pretty much the whole final season of Breaking Bad, because it was just such a heavy thing. But glad to have done it, obviously.
I got to tell you, I remember after he told you to tread lightly.
Yeah.
I needed a minute, actually, in my living room.
Yeah.
I needed a minute in my living room after that scene. I'm not lying. I'm serious.
I know. Yeah. I get you. I think there were many moments in that last season where people literally would just pause the TV and go, what? Wow. And then continue on with it, you know.
Right. And you know, before, again, the actor Dean Norris from the United States of Al, which again airs tonight on CBS at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Vince Gilligan told us that Bryan Cranston would grab a script and he would look at Aaron Paul, who was afraid of getting killed off because his character essentially wasn't supposed to make it out of season one, that he would mess with his head all the time, saying, oh, go through a script. I don't know. You know, like,
did
you ever grab a script and see if that was the end of Hank Schrader at any point in time?
I never was concerned. And I knew 2 years prior that Vince told me 2 years ahead of time what his demise would be. And interestingly enough, he almost said the words that my final words were to me 2 years.
Like, no kidding.
He said, I'm gonna tell you what, Dean, you're gonna die. It's either gonna be the second to last or the last episode, but you're gonna die with your dignity. And he said, you're gonna say something like, you know, yourself and blah blah blah. And I was like, all right, man. And that was 2 years prior.
Wow. What does that mean for an actor, Dean Norris, to know that there's a plan and that there's somebody who's such a genius to have that plan and to know how to play your character from there on out? What does that mean?
Yeah, it was fantastic. I mean, I was one of the few people who never visited the writer's room, because I would think of something and I'd go, you know what? These guys, there's like 10 geniuses in there. They've already been through that option, you know, 10 days ago. So it was great to allow that to unfold with these guys. And it was cool. It was good to know that he was going out on his, not on his terms necessarily, but like Vince said, with his dignity, you know.
Dean Norris here on the Rich Eisen Show at Dean J. Norris on Twitter and Instagram. The United States of Al, again, airing tonight on CBS at 8:30 Eastern Time. This is obviously something completely different. This is a comedy. What did you like about this that you wanted to get involved in all of this, in this show, Dean?
Yeah. Well, you know, Chuck Lorre is what I liked about it, first of all.
That helps. There's no doubt about that. That helps.
When Chuck Lorre calls and says, "Hey, we got a role for you," look at your wife, and she's like, "You're taking that, butter."
I love that. Fantastic.
But what I really liked about it is the fact that it wasn't just a fluffy comedy. It really has a lot of heart to it, and it's about serious stuff, you know, which Chuck Lorre's been getting into more and more lately. You know,
right.
You look at moms and alcoholism and the Kaminsky method and all these different things. So it was important, or it was good that it was about something. Essentially, you know, adjusting military guys adjusting back to civilian life and such. So that made it attractive as a comedy for me.
Right, and then Al is the interpreter who served with the combat veteran who's returning to civilian life, and Al is now from his unit in Afghanistan arriving to start a new life in America, and you play the father of the Marine combat veteran in this show. And so you're right, this is obviously a very deep conversation to have a comedy surround, to say the least, Dean.
And we have some great father-son moments. And I'm going to tell you, Rich, you know, moments I think in the show, not just my moments, but other moments that are as good as any, you know, good drama out there. And then we follow it up with hopefully a hearty laugh. So that's the goal. That's what we feel we're doing. And it's fun doing it.
Dean Norris here on the Rich Eisen Show. Before I let you go, I want to go a little deeper past Breaking Bad, way back when you were in both Total Recall and the second Terminator, Dean Norris. Okay. And you can't be, you're not recognizable in Total Recall because there was all that, you know, I guess prosthetic device over your face, but you're in a scene. You're with Arnold. You got any good Arnold stories from?
Oh man, I that was my second movie. Lethal Weapon 2 was my first. That was my second movie.
Damn.
We shot it down in Mexico, at the Churubusco Studios, and Arnie was like at the peak of his awesomeness. I'll tell you one thing. Two things.
Go for it.
One thing I loved is that he loved to smoke cigars, of course, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you, on close-ups, he would sometimes have a cigar in his hand, puff it out, and do the scene with a cigar in his hand. But it was a close-up, so you didn't see it.
That's boss.
I thought exactly. I'm like, this man rules. And then one time we were out. We were out to dinner and kind of a round table. And in Mexico, these guys would come up and you'd grab these two metal, I don't know what they were, just like metal handles. And then they would spin this box and electricity would go through. And you'd all hold hands to see who would stop, who would let go first.
Come on.
Get this? So we're doing that. And I'm like, I'm going to challenge Arnie Schwarzenegger to who can handle the most electricity. And he beat me.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course he would.
Wow, Dean, though, that takes some guts. That takes some cojones.
Yeah.
No doubt about it. So Lethal Weapon 2 was your first movie?
Yes.
Damn, how'd you get involved in that? What happened?
You know. Just went in, met Dick Donner, man. I was like, hey, you got an audition? And I was waiting tables. And I got this audition, I remember sitting down with Dick Donner, and he's like, yeah, you look like a cop. And I was like, I think I got the role.
Sold. And now you can sell everyone Schrader Brow beer, huh? So you've made a beer out of Hank Schrader's character and, I guess, essence? Is that what you
did? We did. And it was a good beer. It was a limited edition. We got to get it out again. Hopefully we're going to get it out for Oktoberfest.
Let's do it. Hey, Dean, thanks for the call. I got to ask this question before I let you go. Is there any possible Better Call Saulness for you? Do we see anything on that regard?
Yeah, man, I appreciate you asking that, but you know, I couldn't tell you if I was.
I know, but it's worth the shot. It's
Absolutely.
Worth the try because I do love that show. And it just, it's, you know, I thought of you, actually, Dean Norris. I don't know if you, how closely you follow the show at all.
I do.
Okay, great. So you remember the second to last episode of last season where Saul Goodman and Mike Ehrmantraut are in the desert. And
oh, yeah.
And that was the most Breaking Bad feeling episode of Better Call Saul to date. And I thought of you and Bryan Cranston and Walter White and Hank Schrader in the desert, you know, which we've seen those moments. I thought of you in the, I guess, the Ozymandias episode. And
Ozymandias, yeah.
I mean, that had that feeling to it. I can't get enough of it. It's truly
amazing.
I agree.
That was a fantastic episode. That was that outdoorsy feel, but also the feeling of like the Fly episode where they were just stuck.
Yes.
But they were, of course, stuck outside, which is different. But still, that very Breaking Bad feel to that.
And hey, I had to ask Bob Odenkirk a question that I knew he wouldn't give me the answer to. But he did, you know, volunteer that was not his own urine that he was really drinking in that episode. So
it was mine, actually.
Hey, we've got that scoop, everybody. Hey, Dean, thanks for calling. Like I said, I'm a big fan. Let's, despite learning that you're a Notre Dame guy. But let's do this again another time.
Absolutely, man. My pleasure.
Thank you. That's okay. Dean Norris, United States of Al, airs tonight on CBS at 8:30 p.m. Eastern. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.